what is the basic principle of CT scan? See, it says that the internal structure of an object can be reconstructed from multiple projections of that particular object. I'm absolutely sure it doesn't make any sense to you right now. So you've not understood it at all, but that is all right. Wait for a couple of minutes. By the end of the next couple of minutes, when I come back to this statement, you'll understand everything about it. But for that, you must have seen a CT scan machine once, right? This is how a machine looks like, right? Now, this is how the machine looks like, you know, from the front and from the sides. There is a big round structure in the CT scan machine. And this big round structure is what is given the name. It is what is called as the CT scan gantry. And there is a CT scan table. And it is on this particular table, remember, that the patient is going to lie. And it is this table which is going to go inside, it is going to slide inside the machine. And see, this is how the patient goes into the bore, and that is how a CT scan is going to be performed. Now suppose that this table has slided in, the machine has started, and you are standing at the foot end of this particular patient. So where are you standing? You are standing at the foot end of the patient. You are facing directly towards the machine. How would it appear to you? If you are facing towards the machine, this is how it would appear. If you open up the CT scan gantry, what do you see inside? Inside there is an X-ray tube, and there are detectors to detect it, detect the X-ray beam. What is the function of an X-ray tube? The function of the X-ray tube is to produce an X-ray beam. So can you see? An X-ray beam is going to be produced. This X-ray beam is going to pass through the patient's body. So an image is going to be created on the detector. These are electronic detectors. So the image is going to be an electronic image. This particular image which is obtained is given a name. So it is what is called as the first projection. This is an electronic image. So all this data which is collected is going to be transferred to a computer, right? So this data is transmitted to the computer. Now what happens? See, the next step that occurs is very beautiful. See what happens? Look at the animation. Now the X-ray tube is going to be moved to a new position along the circumference. The detectors are also moved. From this new position, same process is repeated. So the X-ray beam is going to be produced. This beam will pass through the patient's body. So we will get another image. So this is what is called as the second projection. Second projection is going to look different from first projection. Data is again transferred to the computer. This process is repeated. See, new position, right? Third projection, fourth projection, so on and so forth. So in this frame, from different angles around the patient's body, n number of projections of the patient's body are obtained. So when we obtain all this data of n number of projections of the patient's body from different angles around the patient's body, all this data is transferred to the computer. What does the computer do? The computer processes all this data. A lot of complex mathematics is applied. And at the end of all the processing, finally, what you see is the CT scan image on the computer screen. Look at this image. This is a CT scan thorax image. Can you see the chest wall? There is the heart shadow, right lung, left lung, vertebral bodies, various details inside the heart, details inside the lungs. So what are you able to see in this particular image? I hope you all agree that in this image, what you are basically seeing is the internal structure of the patient's body. But from what data have I reconstructed this internal structure? I have reconstructed this data from multiple projections, n number of projections of the patient's body. So do you remember what was the basic principle of CT scan? The basic principle of CT scan states that the internal structure of an object can be reconstructed from multiple projections of that particular object. Does it make sense to you now? Yes. So this is how a CT scan basically works. This is the basic principle of CT scan.